had to click a couple of buttons there while we're doing this, Glen, so we can record this and throw it up onto our YouTube channel as well, which is YouTube at What's Brewing PA. Okay. So I picked a beer, Glen. We've had this beer in the past, the Russian from 2SP, but I picked it because it's in a can, which to me is pretty amazing that a 9% Russian Imperial Stout is now being packaged in a can, which is, you know, just one of the great beers. It's a, you know, world champion beer from 2SP down there in Delaware County. And we both love it. Bob Berard, the brewer of this, is a great friend of the show and one of our sure. old podcast guests, actually. So I thought in that spirit, I'd pour this one. I wish I could share it, Glen, with you, because this is a big beer, probably worth having more than one person on a can.
Yeah, that looks terrific. Okay, well, I got from our friends at Ship Bottom, and we do love that brewery down in Longwood, New Jersey, and also, of course, we see them during the summer at Linvilla Orchards. By the way, I do have my What's Brewing mug that you gave me a couple of years ago. So I've got their Swell Dorado Double Hop New England IPA, which is great stuff. 8.5 ABV, excuse me, dry hop, double dry hop, hazy IPA with Pilsner malt. I hope you can hear that as I pour that. High percentage of oats and wheat malts, a silky smooth and extraordinary mouthfeel, and I'm going to enjoy this right now. Mm. Grapefruit, mango, all the good flavors.
I can't good stuff. Quite see, Glen, is that cloudy? Because I know that's your favorite type of beer, but not too
cloudy. I can't you now. I can see nothing. Yeah, great stuff.
Well, you know, I guess, you know, beers like this, you know, not too shabby for us to have these, both of these beers in storage. We could be worse off, I suppose.
Right. It's a fine way to spend. Actually, Ship Bottom was nice enough that they sent this over the house over the last week. I know you got a batch as well.
Right. We're going to have them on our show eventually too. So
yeah. Speaking of which, in delivery today, I got this from our friends at Yingling. I got to tell you, they put a lot into the packaging. This box is one I'm going to save for a nice wooden box. But what's in it is what they bill as the next generation of light beer. I'm not going to open it now because it's warm from sitting in front of my house. This is the Yingling Flight. It's a light beer, 2.6 carbs, 95 calories, 4.2 ABV. I've not tried it. I'm not usually a big fan of the light beers. Certainly, well, I hope this is going to last till the warm weather because that's when you go this. But thanks to the nice people at Yingling for sending this one along.
Well, having already put on my COVID-15, I think I may have to switch to the light beer eventually. Maybe not.
Yeah, right. All right. So let's talk a little news, then let's have a little fun. You mentioned to me that we've seen the first kind of regional casualty in the local beer industry related to what's going on right now.
Yeah, we talked about this last week on the web and about the possibility of breweries going to start closing. And the first one has, it looks like, in the Pittsburgh area, Full Pint Brewing, which is a familiar one to Philly people because their beers have been in our market for quite a while. They were already nearing some economic problems, it looked like. They weren't growing enough. And the brewer earlier this week decided to pull the plug. He had a post on Instagram in which he said, "I would be lying if I was to say that I'm not tearing up as I type this." Really sad to hear that.
Yeah. Well, that is a shame. And when we talk about it, you think we're going to see some more of these?
Unfortunately, I do. The whole model of the new breweries has been to bring people into the tap room and drink the beers right there. And, you know, when you can't, you know, when you have social distancing, you cannot go to a tap room and they're all closed. The only way to get the beer these days is takeout.
I don't think I've ever tried any of those beers. They do sell locally.
Yeah, they do. Actually, you know what, Glen, one of them, the Chinookie IPA, was in the very first beer bracket that we did. It was one of the IPAs, and it is a really fine beer. I think the one that they were best known for is their White Lightning, which was a wit beer, a really fine beer. I'm going to miss that beer.
Okay. So let's talk about what's going on in the market right now. You have not yet watched the Netflix sensation Tiger King. Is that correct?
No, I've not. I've missed it. I hear it's going to be one of those classics out there. I don't know. I haven't had the time, I guess.
Oh, yeah. My wife and I rifled through that thing in about 4 days, 7 episodes. It definitely shows humanity at its worst, but I will tell you that I think it's worth checking out. Anyway, it has sparked, not surprisingly, a ton of beers which are so-called tiger beers. How do you want to refer to this?
Tiger whatever, I guess.
Yeah, okay. And I have to tell you, we at Conshohocken Brewing, not exempt from this. The cans are going to be out later this week, but we did, and I'm going to turn this around so you can see it. Hopefully, tell me if this is coming up on the screen.
Yes, it does.
Nice label, right?
It is. It's a sour IPA, I noticed.
I saw a Tiger sour IPA, tart unfiltered IPA with Citra and Columbus hops, conditioned on orange and lemon peel, 4.6 ounces. So that's our effort. And by the way, a percentage of the sales goes to local agencies designed to protect the wildlife. So it's a beer that's got a charitable cause.
So there you go, our high-tech production efforts there in full view.
Right, sales go to Animal Rescue, and you said there are other breweries that are doing this right now.
Yeah, Evil Genius locally has also made one called Felt Cute Might Feed My Husband to a Tiger Later. I don't know.
That's a thing. That's the one of the women who's the show focuses on. Allegedly, her husband did disappear, never to be seen again. And there is a strong belief that she actually killed him, ground him up, and served him to the lions. Yes.
Yum. I don't know, Glenn. It sounds like very, you know, really high concept TV there to me.
Let me tell you, you're going to be inside for the next whatever. You may want to check it out. It's right. Worth watching, and it's worth drinking a beer. There are other collaborations going on right now. Good stuff going on. The All Together Beer collaboration, what do we know about that?
Yeah, Other Half Brewing up in Brooklyn got this thing launched. It's very reminiscent of the Sierra Nevada Resilience Project a few years ago after that big campfire. We talked a lot about that on the show. And in this case, they're raising money the Other Half Brewing has started this project to raise money for hospitality professionals in any community where this beer is going to be made. So the idea is that they share the recipe, the label art, and then local breweries will sign on and make their own versions of it. I hope there's some collaborations, perhaps. Don't know if that's possible. But already Tom's River and Three Threes in Jersey, those breweries are going to be doing it. And we heard from our friends up in Bucks County that Odd Logic and Second Sin will also be making a version of it. And you can, beer drinkers can support the whole project. Go to alltogether.beer on the web.
Nice. Very nice. By the way, as we're doing this show, we are getting comments. I might as well read a few of them. Some people are talking about what they're drinking, Joe Sixpack. Timothy McKeever is enjoying a Port Omnis Stout 6.2 can from Kane.
Cool.
Good stuff there. Stanley Twarek is enjoying the Yard's Filthy. I don't know the Yard's Filthy.
I'm not sure which one he is. Stan's a great guy. He's my bicycle mechanic.
Oh, well, there you go. Nice work. Susan Chiach, sorry if I mispronounce your name, is having this is going to be tough. Wyhen Stefaner Hefeweizen.
Great beer. I love it. It's like maybe the best Hefeweizen out there. Fantastic beer from the oldest brewery in the world.
Brad Rich is having said reaching into the back of the fridge for a Mad Elf. Still got one of those around.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, mine are gone. Gracie Shelty, a 2SP Delco Lager. That's a nice beer. Had that. Mike Gemmel, I'm sorry if I'm mispronouncing your names, folks. Gemmel. Says, where are the hazy IPAs at? Right here, Mike. Right here, baby. That's his jam, too. Bob Banash, our friend Bob Banash, says, greetings from New Hampshire. Mike Keller says, cheers. Richard Schwartz says, loud and clear. So we appreciate the people are out here viewing us as we basically sit around and invent a happy hour by drinking a beer. All right. We asked when we posted that we were going to do this for people to give us their best stories about getting drunk because these are tough times. We want people to have some fun. So let me read a few that we got from people who are viewing us right now. And if you are watching us on Facebook Live and you can type it up real fast, we'll put it out there. A guy named Matt Dargan says, my friend and I got drunk in Boston. We had no way to get home because the train stopped at midnight, hopped in a cab and woke up hours later at the international terminal of Logan Airport near a bunch of people speaking French.
And not on the flight, or I'm not sure I caught that whole thing.
They're just at the terminal.
Okay.
Mike Condon, who I happen to know, he's a great chef. Chef Michael says, the year was 2007. I think I was 23. I had the bright idea to chug an entire bottle of Black House, you'll tell me what that is, and passed out on the hood of a car in a snowstorm and slept like a baby through the storm.
All right. I have no idea what Black House is. It sounds dangerous, though.
Andrew Colligan, another good guy. Night of the Eagles Super Bowl 52. And yeah, I bet there are a lot of stories.
Yeah, that. Right.
Watched the game at a friend's house in Fishtown. Right after the games, ended up, we marched from their house to the L with a half-full sixtel of Manny Young Brewery beer in hand. Took the L to Broad Street, serving people beer from the keg along the way. That's a good guy on the train. Had to carry the keg around all night with me after it kicked, but it was well worth it.
Wow. That's impressive, actually.
And one more I'll give you from the Beer Whisperer, who the Beer Whisperer, whenever we post stuff on social media during our show, always has great comments. He says, well, there was this one time at a Jimmy Buffett concert at BB&T. We tailgated for about 8 hours before the show, pounding 8% IPAs. By the time Southern Cross got played, I was convinced my pants just had to come off. Luckily, some good friends convinced me otherwise.
I suspect he would not have been the only one at a Jimmy Buffett concert with his pants off. So,
all right, I'll give you mine real quick. It's a true story. I was in college. I think most of these people's stories, you know, go back to when you were younger, although Super Bowl 52 wasn't that long ago.
No.
For me, it's back in the day when I was in college. I was at a bar. I think it was Harvard Square. Walked into the men's room, bumped into somebody by the door. I apologized. Stood there for like a full 5 minutes, Joe Sixpack, before I realized I hadn't bumped into another person. I'd walked into a full-length mirror, and I was waiting. essentially for the guy in the mirror, me, to finish up and move. So that's mine. What about you?
Mine was probably a little bit more embarrassing, Glen.
Yeah, I really embarrassed myself, right?
Exactly. I basically managed with a friend to embarrass myself in front of an entire stadium full of baseball fans down at the Baltimore's Old Memorial Park a number of years ago when I was there for a bachelor party for a good friend. And about 10 of us were together and drinking quite a bit all day. And we ended up going to the game and we had tickets. We had great tickets, a whole row. You know how hard it is to get 10 people together in a stadium?
Oh, yeah.
We did that. And when we got to our seats, however, there was an elderly woman sitting smack in the middle of where we're supposed to be seating. And, you know, we were a little bit buzzed and probably a little rude. And we basically ran her off out of her seat. none too pleased. And maybe around the fourth or fifth inning, they bring the stadium cam around and they have it on our group. You know, they show everybody in our group. We're all waving and such. And then they keep going down the aisle until they get to the little old lady who had just moved a few seats down there. And they focus on her, same lady we had bumped out of her seat. And the scoreboard in big letters announces that it's her 80th birthday. And she is the Orioles' most loyal fan, been going to every game for like 30, 40 years. And as they focus on her, she's looking back at us with that little old lady, you know, scowl. Drunken idiots.
Nice work. That is truly embarrassing. By the way, just a couple other people have checked in with what they're drinking. Let me see. Jessica Breslin Bonner is having some stouts and Sly Fox Black Lager. Nice for you. Jeff Sides is saying damn good Pilsner from Snitz Creek. I don't know Snitz Creek. Do you know that brewery?
There's the Black Lager.
There you go.
Snitz Creek, yes. I've seen it before, yes.
Mikey Leister is enjoying 100 Acres honey from Conshy Brewing. And by the way, my next beer today is going to be my favorite from Conshy Brewing, the MC5, which it's going to kick soon. We made it. Going to go. It's my favorite beer at Conshy Brewing, and I got some of the last ones. Want it, here's what I'm going to tell people. This is endorsement for myself or whatever, serving myself. The Conshocken Brewing Company places, the Town Tap, the Rec Room in Phoenixville, Conshy, all of them are open for curbside service. You can get takeout. I got a prof burger yesterday at the Town Tap, and you can order the beer to go. Just call them up, and they will bring it to you out in the curb. I know a lot of breweries are doing that right now, and it's really important to the industry. Any restaurant. You know what? I want to speak for everybody. If you've got a restaurant that you like, a brew pub that you like, a brewery, like whatever, you want to support them during these tough times, call them up. Most of them have takeout. You just sit in your car. They bring it outside. You take it home. All's good. And they wear the gloves.
That's great. But I did miss the boat on the MC5. Is that what you're telling me?
Well, if you get out tonight, I know where you live. you can get yourself to Manayunker to the Town Tap. Your old Town Tap's in your old neighborhood where you grew up.
Yep, in Havertown. Yeah,
you can get it. You can get it for the next few days. A couple people. People are telling us what they're drinking. Joe Sixpack.
It's great.
Michael Brzezinski is having a Root and Branch Life and Care 4. Jim Chapman is enjoying a Ship Bottom Barnegat Light. We like that beer. That's a nice one. Tom Sarensitz, is having a Funk Double Citrus up here in State College. Thanks for watching up there. We like that Funk Double Citrus. That's a nice beer. Let me see if I have any others. Paul McDowell having a Punk IPA from Brewdog. You know that beer?
That's a huge selling beer. You find it actually almost anywhere, especially in Europe these days.
You say Europe?
Yeah, they're a Scottish brewery.
Okay. Michael Friedman is having a Warwick Farms FYT Pils, probably one you would like. Bill Rogers enjoying an Aslin Sparkling Wine Shower. All right. We'll take that. We're not just limited to beer on this show.
Yeah.
Mike Crispy is having an Evil Genius No Crying in Baseball Mango IPA. That's a new one to me.
I've not had that one. And, you know, Glenn yesterday would have been opening day down at the ballpark for the film.
Oh. You know what? It's so funny because I'm trying to watch sports and watch games that were played. All the stations, ESPN, NBC Sports Philadelphia, WIP, we're playing old classic games, right? WIP is airing the Nick Foles 7-touchdown game against the Raiders. And
oh, wow.
NBC Sports Philadelphia has shown the Phillies, you know, World Series games. It's really hard for me to watch those old games. It makes me miss it more. It makes me sad.
I know. I was listening to old Harry Callis home running calls earlier today. A best of best hits tape or something.
Yep. Our friend the Beer Whisperer is having a Trillium launch beer.
Wow.
He wins.
I guess, did he make a side trip up there, I wonder, to pick up that beer? That's a rare one.
Andrew Colligan's having a Rothaus Pils.
Hold on, that's the second one he's drank. Is he already onto his second beer?
he's busy. Let me just see what's going on here. Bob Benash, it's his second one. He ring the bell from Conshy Brewing. Thank you very much. That's been a good one for us. Okay, let's get on to our next topic. I'll read more of what people have to say, but I appreciate it. You wanted to do a thing on social media that we're following. What's your idea here?
Yeah, I mean, Glenn, so many of us are keeping in touch, and you have a ton of Twitter followers, and I have a few. I love
at @beer_radar on Twitter. That's you, and I am at Real Glenn Macnow, and the show is at What's Brewing PA. Yes, go.
And one of the things that sort of keeps me going is just the whole idea of what other people are posting. And obviously, there's a lot of bad news out there on Twitter and Facebook and so on, but there's a lot of good stuff that's just fun to watch and keeps my spirits up. And I just thought, you know, I wanted to talk to you a little bit about what you're following these days. I'll tell you one of my favorites that I've been following. I don't know how I discovered this one. I stumbled across it, but I can highly recommend it. It is it's at Communist Bops, and we'll post this here.
What?
Communist Bops, it's called, like the Communist BOPS, but that's not how you're going to find it. You need to search for Soviet soldiers dancing. and it is fantastic. It is one of my favorites. It's these old videos or films from the 30s and 40s of Soviet soldiers dancing like crazy. But whoever has put them up has updated it to modern music, and it is fantastic. It's fun, a lot of good stuff. Skills when we out and cruising, got warrants in every city except Houston, but I still ain't losing. They see me rolling, they hating, patrolling and trying to catch me riding dirty, 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 trying to catch me riding dirty. My music's so loud.
Okay, I have not seen that. I'll give you a couple that I absolutely love. Rex Chapman, the former NBA player, is the single best person to follow on Twitter. He does a thing called block or charge, which is, of course, NBA. Is it a block or is it a charge? And he started out by just doing funny videos of essentially people running into things, including each other, and saying, is this a block or a charge? But he's expanded it out, and he posts, I would say, a good half a dozen to 10 videos a day. Some of them are funny. Some of them are compelling. These days, some of them will really get you right here.
It's on. Is it on?
It's on. Okay.
All right, we're on.
Garage door assisted Corona.
Chugging challenge.
All right.
All right, hang on.
Assume the position.
Wait, got it. Get ready.
Shit.
I don't think we missed a drop.
Jacob Barb?
I'm pretty sure we got it all.
You're up.
Really, the content that we need right now, Rex Chapman is the best follow there is on Twitter.
That's a good one. Actually, I started following him because of you. I know you had reposted a couple, but a lot of fun videos there for sure.
I'll tell you a couple others that are really worth following. There's a thing, if you just want silly, right, which is where we're going here.
Yes.
Follow, there's one called Faces in Things on Twitter. Would you ever walk down the street and you look at the back of a car and you go like, God, that looks like a smiling face? This is an entire Twitter account of things that look like a human face. Might be a tree stump, might be a wall, might be a piece of equipment, but that's it. Faces in Things is a really good follow, just for fun. And the other one, since we're doing a show about beer, is called Hold My Beer, which, as you can imagine, Joe Sixpack, is an entire Twitter account of people doing stupid things where you would say, like, oh, yeah, I can beat that. Hold my beer. I'll ride my bicycle off the cliff.
Yeah, right, right. Okay, that's worth it. Although, you know, I've shared those videos before with the missus, and she doesn't like it because she says, somebody's going to get hurt doing that.
Sometimes, yeah. My wife cracks it up. I guess my wife's a little more sadistic than yours. So, there you go. By the way, just getting some more comments here. Michael Brzezinski, I guess he's on his second one. Kelly Green Suntan Jelly.
We actually got that beer on the show, or rather on a podcast some time ago over in Jersey. They have a number of jelly beers, real good. And you know what? Kelly Green, as in the Eagles. That's where they got their name from.
Timothy McKeever, well, this isn't about beer, but we were talking about watching old games, and one of the ones that's been showing is the Roy Halladay no-hitter. They showed that. He said, my daughter was born that day, and I still couldn't watch it the other day.
It is so, even right down to the last play with Ruiz picking up that ball, I just, somebody, yeah.
Can I tell you, and actually, this is something you wanted to talk about, is the best. Oh, no, I'm confusing this with my show tomorrow on WIP. I'm on tomorrow 10-1 on WIP with Ray Dinger, and we're having Big Daddy Graham as a guest, and he wants to do a thing on the best games you ever attended. I'm confusing my shows. And this beer is more powerful than you think.
Yeah.
And he wants to do a thing on the best games you ever attended, and for me, one of the best games I ever attended live was that Roy Halladay no-hitter.
Oh, you were there. Cool. Cool.
Yeah, play the end by Ruiz was just fantastic. Joanne Brown says, I was saving my last CBS for a special occasion. Decided to drink it right now with you guys. What's the CBS?
That's a Canadian Breakfast Stout from Founders.
Great. Oh, yep. There you go. Mike Bonner's drinking a Broken Chair JJ's Irish Red. Andrew Colligan heard you mention how many beers he's drinking. He says, hey, nothing better to do than drink beer right now.
And watch us.
Kristen Panaski is drinking a Victory Easy Ringer. Her husband is drinking a Blue Moon, says, love the show. Thank you, Kristen. We appreciate that. And Mike Monteleone says, Treehouse is so good. Yes, indeed, it is. No question about it. Also, you wanted to do a little TV show recommendations?
Yeah, what else are we doing here? You got a favorite show out there these days? Other than that stupid Tiger show?
So my two things. My wife and I decided, because I do watch a lot of TV and I talk about it on the air, that this was a good opportunity, since we're going to be stuck inside for a long time, to watch stuff we've never watched. So I downloaded the American Film Institute list of the 100 best movies of all time and I went through it, you know, seen it, never saw it, seen it, saw it when I was 18. That's a long time ago. And we decided to watch all the movies that one of us had never seen before.
Okay.
Or had seen so long ago. So I've spent the last 2 weeks watching Lawrence of Arabia, Bridge Over the River Kwai, Sunset Boulevard, City Lights, Double Indemnity, these great old movies. And can I tell you, they're great.
I know,
they're
classics.
Just great.
You know what I was amazed at on those older movies is the actors were not, and actresses, I guess they're all actors, but they were not necessarily beautiful people. They used all types of, I mean, you know, you watch some of those old Humphrey Bogart movies and Sidney Greenstreet is in there.
Yeah. You know? Well, last night we watched Treasure of the Sierra Madre.
Right, right.
Another great movie.
Oh, that is right. We don't need no stinking badges.
Yes. That's a great line. What are you watching?
Well, I'm not so up there with that kind of classy stuff, Glenn, although I do love all those movies. I will tell you that the TV show that I really have loved, and it wasn't just a quarantine show, it's a show that's been on for the last couple of years, is Schitt's Creek on Pop TV. You have to look around a little bit for it. Fantastic comedy series. It's sort of like a Green Acres-esque comedy of the extremely wealthy family moving into basically an armpit of a town that they bought on a joke. Great cast with Eugene Levy and Catherine O'Hara, who's just absolutely
wonderful. They're both terrific. From the old SCTV.
Yes, exactly. Chris Elliott is in it. But the real star of this show is a guy, Dan Levy, who is Eugene's son, who both created and wrote the episodes. Fantastic. The last episode is this week. It's a really sweet show, very funny, just an outstanding little series.
All right. By the way, Bill Rogers just popped a Dewey Beer Company Swishy Pants.
From Delaware,
I guess. There you go. Yeah. Al Ford says, hey, I ran out of IPA, so I'm drinking a Ship-Bottom Barnegat Lager. That beer a lot.
Yeah.
That's a very nice beer. That's good work by him. Also, by the way, on Netflix, new show coming out. I have to tell you, I'm very leery of this. It's an 8-episode show called Bruise Brothers, which is going to be a comedy series. It drops next week. It's from the guys who did the show The League. Did you ever watch The League?
Oh, yeah, I loved The League. It was great.
Okay, well, then you'll like this. It's about two brothers, estranged brothers, who wind up running a brewery together. According to Netflix, each is a beer genius, but they couldn't be more different in their beer making techniques and personalities. A lot of times in a show you see two people who complete each other. These two don't even make a full person. I watched the trailer for this. It looks really stupid.
It could be hard to pull off. So it's not a documentary, it's actual
No. It's a comedy show about two brothers who own a brewery.
All right. Well, you know what? I'll give it a stab and see what it's like. You know, there's been the beer as a subject matter in movies and TV is uneven. I mean, some are great, some are not so great. So,
yeah. Well, it's by the same guys who did The League, which was about fantasy football. And so, like fantasy football, brew pubs are a big deal, topical, and so on. So, they made a show. We'll see. Real quickly, we've got some videos up on YouTube. You did a great interview with Carol Stout.
Yeah, I loved it. Unfortunately, it had to do with the closing of Stout's, imminent closing that Carol announced last month. And so I sat down with her with an extensive interview. It's three parts on our YouTube channel, which is What's Brewing PA. She was very gracious with her time and beer, and I really enjoyed it quite a bit. And we have our other past shows are back there, plus some shorts you and I have done over the last couple months.
Yeah, one including whether or not it's acceptable to have ice cubes in beer, which actually brings me to a point from a guy who emailed me today and wants our advice on this, and I'll defer to you, Joe Sixpack. You're the expert. He says he accidentally froze some beer. I guess cans of beer. It's not the bottles that would explode. And he said, are they still good? Can I still drink them?
Well, that's two different questions, Glenn. Of course you can still drink it. What's the worst that could happen to you, right?
I think he means, is quality going to be impacted?
Yeah, the quality probably not. Will probably be degraded. You just got to test it and find out. I suspect it won't taste as good as you thought it would. If you let it defrost, if it were me, I might be tempted to, if you can get to it, to scrape off some of the ice, get rid of that, and then drink what's left. It might be an interesting beer, sort of like an ice beer.
All ice. What's that? It's a slush. I think it's all ice. I think it's
slush. Yeah. I'm not sure really what to say about that. So,
I think what you said is right, which is give it a try.
Yeah.
Go wrong.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. By the way, our friend Mike Monteleone is drinking a main lunch. Oh, that's another a good choice there.
Yeah, really nice.
We got a question from a guy named Dave Wynn. Beer suggestions for the bourbon drinker who can't get bourbon.
Oh, man, that's a disaster.
Yeah. I would get something barrel-aged, right?
Yeah, there's a lot of barrel-aged stuff out there. The beers from Weyerbacher that are barrel-aged are excellent. I would look for them. I'm trying to think if that CBS beer that from Founders, whether that's actually in a bourbon barrel. It might be. So, to stay local, I would definitely suggest those the beers from Weyerbacher that are barrel-aged.
A lot of people checking in, and we really appreciate it. Let's get to some odds and ends. Mackenzie Brewhouse, Delco and in Chester County, what are they up to?
They are, along with several other folks out there, they are actually making their own hand sanitizer. I'm not sure how they made it, but they made their own brand, and you can get it at the brew pub. They have several locations in Delaware County and Chester County. So another good way to support a local brewery.
Yeah, absolutely. Good idea. Good work by them. Iron Hill. They've got grocery bundles and craft meal kits. What are they up to?
Yeah, we mentioned, you were just mentioning before about Conshy Brewing, where you pick up at the curbside. That's very common these days with the breweries. Iron Hill has taken another step forward where you, in addition to getting meals to go, you can also get what they're calling grocery bundles, to allow you to make food at home or beer, I'm sorry, to allow you to make meals at home. But the bundles include eggs and butter and milk and fruit and vegetables. So if you're having problems getting to the shop right or whatever, you might check out Iron Hill as well.
All right, let me tell you some more what people are telling us. We talk about stouts and they're going out of business. Gracie Shelty says, geez, I used to make run to stouts to get those big bottles of Malbec. She made some great beer. She did make some great beer. She was really a pioneer. We talked about that before.
Yeah.
He was great. George Cesarini says, hey guys, my 98-year-old mother likes ice in her beer. Who am I to tell her that she's wrong?
You know, really, why harsh somebody's buzz? Come on.
And Gary Hill is drinking some Hill Homestead IPA. Good for him. Okay, also in the news, the devil finds work for idle hands. What are you talking about?
One of these days we're going to be able to figure out how to share all this on our show, Glenn, but for the moment I want to direct people to Spellbound Brewing's recent posting. It's on YouTube, but I think you can go to their website and find it. Spellbound over in Jersey, I guess Mount Holly, has produced for April 1st, a wonderful video that announce their new drone delivery service. Totally worth going to check that
out. Oh, yeah? Okay. This is not the year to do April Fool's jokes, I will say that. And let's wrap it up with this. Next Tuesday, which is whatever, 5 days for Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, 4 days from now, is National Beer Day. I didn't know such a thing existed.
Well, it's kind of a made-up holiday, but it's a good made-up holiday. But it
all are, yeah.
Exactly. It specifically commemorates the day in 1933, April 7th, 1933, when FDR signed a law into or signed a bill into an act into law, I guess that's what you do, called the Cotton-Harrison Act, which legalized the sale of non-intoxicating beverages. And in this case, he meant 3.2 beer, which was, you know, basically the end of prohibition as far as beer was concerned. Huge day because, Roosevelt marked the occasion by saying as a famous remark, "I think today would be a good time for a beer." And he was so right, among other things.
Right.
The Anheuser-Busch people, who were totally on the ball on this one, they got together. They introduced for the very first time the Budweiser Clydesdales, which were used to deliver the beer to Al Smith, the governor of New York.
Which you had written. I once said that, like, I got to see the Clydesdales and touch them, and then you one-upped me and said, like, oh, yeah, I've ridden on top of them.
I did, and I hope it was at the anniversary of, I think it was the 150th anniversary of McGillin's Old Ale House in Center City. They brought in the Clydesdale, and they allowed me to get up there on the wagon, which was so great. I mean, those horses are really big.
They're huge.
Yeah.
I couldn't, when I saw them, they're huge, and they don't use them. They don't use them in the ads these days, which is a shame.
Yeah, yeah. So they go way back, though. Those were purchased as a gift for Augie Bush, but I'm not sure about that. Anyway, they brought those. They brought the carriage to New York for Al Smith, and then they also, I think, they actually delivered a case of beer down in D.C. to FDR. And on the first day, 24 hours, Americans drank 1.5 million barrels of beer to mark National Beer Day. So you can celebrate it on Tuesday. April 7th.
That's a long time ago, and it's nice to find anything to celebrate these days. These are tough times, and, you know, just we're hoping that everybody can get through it and, you know, deal with the tough times we're facing right now. Joe Sixpack, this was a lot of fun.
It was. I'm happy. Hopefully it's out there on the internets. And as I said, we're going to post this on YouTube. If you want to go back, if our viewers missed part of it, they can certainly go back and take a look at it. But it was great to have so many people join us here.
Yes. And we hope we appreciate everybody who was part of it, everybody who joined us. We'll do it again. Let me put it this way. We got nowhere to go.
Right, right. And I hope that in the future we're going to get some local brewers to join us, because I think we can do, I'll figure out how to get a third person in this mix.
I got to tell you, and really, all praise to your wife who figured this out. Let's be honest, you're inept at this.
Though. Yeah, exactly. She deserves all the credit. Maybe we'll get her on the show sometime.
Yeah, good work by her. Thank you, everybody, for joining us. We'll be back, and thanks for following us, and everybody. We're going to get through this. There is another side. We will be delighted to see you on the other side. Cheers to you. Joe Sixpack, until I see you again.
All right.
All right. Take care.